brackets, in bracket, dam, barrier, embankment, and I want to add one more, leakage.
हाँ, leakage, leakage हम लिया है.
That is control, try to be controlled. This river leakage is based upon that.
Yes.
Excuse me, that point, when we are accepting the periodic floods
are
an integral part of the river, they become more fierce. When you say more fierce and how you are, so
then we are saying they are,
you are contradicting the first statement. So they become, yeah.
More can be removed.
Fine. Okay. So now this use of river water will actually go to the other section, but is the formulation okay?
Which one?
Yeah.
The by policy and law, the first priority of use of river water should be to meet the requirements of river health and basic needs of the riparian community. This doesn't belong to this section, it belongs to some other section. But is the formulation okay? Now, impacts on river form shall be assessed when here we are also bringing lateral, longitudinal and vertical connectivity.
But that is not in view of the first reference to the connectivity.
Now, here we are specifically talking of embankment. An embankment restricts the lateral spread of river waters and breaks the river's lateral connectivity. So it is there. These provide a false sense of security from floods to people and enable new habitations in the active floodplains post creation of embankments. Then, this is because while low level floods do get contained within the space between embankments, but these very embankments on breach during high floods become the reason of widespread misery and loss of life and property.
As has been experienced in the Kosi.
Now we are coming to river needs space to accommodate floods. That space shall be determined with reference to the temporal and spatial variability of the 100-year return flood and left free to the river. The dangers inherent in developing river floodplains have recently been witnessed. A devastating effect, first in Uttarakhand in June 2013 and in Jammu and Kashmir in Assam in September 2014. Long pending river zone regulation notification and coverage shall be urgently notified to safeguard the river floodplains.
सर हमारा महाराष्ट्र का कुछ नहीं आया है.
प्लीज सर
वी आर अस्यूमिंग दैट अ रिवर कैन बी मैनेज्ड बाय अ स्ट्रिप ऑन इट्स साइड्स. On the other hand, we have been repeatedly saying that the system consists in the entire basin.
Yeah.
So, in the view of our perception that the river consists of the entire basin and should be dealt with accordingly, we should not so much emphasize the river regulation. It will be wrong direction.
Actually, sir, it is. When we say it is, that name, actual name is river zone regulation. It is not called as river regulation zone. The notification which is under consideration is river zone regulation. And when we say river zone, this includes every river, every tributary as a zone, big river as a zone of its floodplain where the riparian influences are there. So, and that notification is primarily to ensure what is possible and what is not possible. What can be done, what cannot be done. Today, there is no statutory provision to say what can be done and what cannot be done. Like the statue coming in, right, bang in the river Narmada, there is no statutory prohibition on that. And that is why it is coming. So this notification will only ensure that such misadventures are not even thought of. That is the idea.
Yeah, the only issue is in the last 3 days of discussion, we don't discuss this particular notification. You know, we don't know how progressive the how progressive the contents of this, no? And we don't know because
we discuss that.
We don't discuss.
It has been discussed in other groups, not in your group.
Okay. But in the larger plenary it doesn't come out, no? And we don't know how.
So it should have been there in the plenary. Aapke plenary mein nahi aaya tha.
Broadly mentioned kiya gaya tha, but it was not reported in detail because
we need to discuss it.
So you don't want to be.
Fine.
You can say appropriate regulation shall something like that.
Okay, fine. So we will. We can take that out.
No, don't take it out. Modify. It'll be discussed in one group. It should just modify.
No, we will modify. Okay. Yeah. Now the catchment area is the area from which the vegetation on the catchment holds back the soil from being used and increasing the sediment load. Protection of the river therefore requires the protection and restoration of the catchment, its soil and riparian vegetation. This is, I think, quite straightforward. Now we are talking about riverbed. Riverbed is a vital part of the river. Sand mining from the riverbed amounts to the removal of vital organ of the river. Detailed impact assessment shall precede any section of sand removal from riverbeds. Use of machinery for sand extraction shall be prohibited. Is that fine?
commercial agriculture in the river bed also a threat.
Encroachments like this.
Commercial agriculture in the river bed.
Traditional?
Only sand mining is there. Huge commercial agriculture in the river bed.
Okay.
It is not huge.
It is huge, yeah. The part I am talking.
So we are saying we can say any mining.
As long as it's a consumption, just is no problem at all. But export oriented agriculture.
The bed will be smaller or bigger.
Mahanadi is a large
commercial thing.
Yeah,
can I lots of pesticides.
Okay. So that's the traditional use of rivers for navigation and commerce is well known. So we are making a building up a case against what is planned. But this was before the period when barrages and dams on rivers were not there. With highly restricted lean season flow, the river's ability to support navigation is extremely limited. Current plans to turn rivers navigable once again through active human intervention like dredging and creation of barrages to further impound the river waters is fraught with grave danger to the river system and shall be avoided.
Your barrages are not really helping navigation, they are stopping navigation.
No. All the barrages are planned. Like Mississippi, they are enabling the ships to actually get transport like the Panama Canal from lower level to higher level and all those things. That is the plan. So, when we say barrage, these are the 16 barrages between Allahabad and Haldia, which our friend Gadkari ji is planning for navigation.
Really?
Yes.
Barrage
is
locked.
So now this I think should be presented to the minister. Now nature has linked again. This is again from the minister. Nature has linked number of rivers with one another in an intricate network that goes to form the basin of a river system. Within a basin, the smaller rivers meet and lose themselves into larger ones. The larger one then conveys the combined flows. Engineering projects like interlinking of rivers, which plan to divert flows from one river basin to another, are without any scientific justification. and are unnatural and hence shall be avoided.
Banned. Banned from Kingston already.
Prohibited.
Prohibited.
Skills cannot lose, instead of loss, we should merge with the
merge. Okay, fine, fine. We can use the term merge.
This is also a place where you can bring in biodiversity, because one problem is that each river system has its own unique biodiversity. You can't mix the two up. So you can also mention that in part.
Okay. Excuse me.
And the classification we can add ecologically and socially to the code.
Okay, scientific justification, ecologically, socially.
I think the interlinking river project should be mentioned specifically.
It is written there.
ILR.
ILR, okay.
It is written, interlinking of rivers.
Okay, the name
engineering,
is
we have said engineering projects like interlinking of rivers.
So you put in the bracket ILR.
Within bracket I.
But the I capital is there already.
But your minister is a great supporter of that.
That is yes, what
they should come in. They should come in. Actually, they should come earlier, actually. This interlinking point should come earlier.
Okay.
I would not really be comfortable with the word unnatural, because even our khals and pools of Himachal are also unnatural. They are mini engineering works that people do on their own through traditional technologies. So I think we should not get hung up on the word unnatural. We should say destructive.
Okay. Fine.
I mean, the issue is about the destruction they cause vis-a-vis the gain that is.
Fine.
I think the important here is that you need to decide what is the message you want to give to the minister. Rather than telling her that we think your government is doing great things, I think the important thing for them to realize is that in the general aura of popularity, there is no support for the sorts of things they are planning in the water resources project. Now that is the important message. If they are doing one or two good things, fine, that's the job of the government. And it's not our job to tell them, okay, you're doing good things. They must know that from this very large gathering, a voice is coming which represents every part of the country. Because that might, lead them to rethink. Otherwise, the current government is not thinking. What we don't rethink is not even thinking, it's just going ahead and acting. So, I would suggest pick these up strongly and put them across campus. If you don't mind, it might at the end of the day she might be upset with you, but it would be worthwhile.
So
it is not in the mention of Ganga is fine.
So what you are suggesting, sir, let us forget carrot and let us only talk of steak.
Many carrots.
The lady, let us appreciate that she is concentrating on the Ganga.
What is the house's view?
No,
I'm only saying because as we have been told that minister has given only 25 million. So in that, you will have to produce a summary of this.
You should do it,
because
I think let's now go through.
Yeah.
Okay.
Sir, please say, mind should also include boulders.
We have taken that down. Okay.
Yes, mother.
What is happening? Protection from pollution.
The best protection of a river from pollution is the complete prevention of pollutants and contaminants from entering it. Cleaning up of polluted rivers cannot be seen in isolation. Cleaning shall be seen as a natural corollary of the process of river restoration. A truly aviral river is naturally Nirmal.
I will say truly aviral river is a prerequisite for Nirmal.
Okay.
It's not aviral can also be
is a prerequisite.
Aviral sewage.
But may I just point out that you will always generate sewage in big cities. And we have to take account of the big cities and reduce the treatment process. However,
we are coming to that treatment process. So, cleaning should be seen as a truly Aviral river is a prerequisite to a developed river. That is what you are saying. Is a prerequisite to a developed river. Now, sewage from human habitation is a useful resource for the farm sector. Cities must plan on robust management of sewage, which says collection, treatment and use. A river and sewer should have no link. A reuse plan must be drawn up for each major sewer in urban settlements with priority for use in proximity, be it for non-potable domestic use, landscaping, horticulture or urban farming. Here that point about why fresh water should be used for toilet flushing. Similarly, river is not a receptacle for effluent from industries. Industries shall plan and implement zero discharge practices. With in situ reuse of treated effluent wastewater in its entirety. So we will reword it slightly, but if the spirit is fine, then we can go forward.
But you see, you will have to treat sewage in the big cities.
Yeah.
And we must say that
that is another point. I am coming to that. That is another point. Now, it shall be first understood as to why, despite river cleaning being a state policy and large amounts of money having been spent on it, since 1984, no river in the country has been cleaned till date. Our reliance on major infrastructure projects and centralized sewage treatment plants at huge expense have not succeeded. We shall go for decentralized treatment, reuse and recycle model, and use more non-electric or non-powered, non-mechanized, low-cost options for sewage treatment, including resorting to eco-sanitation projects. This is what you are trying to say.
See that today they are aligned with the norm of 30 BOD for treatment before the we must insist on 10.
We are not saying that
they can decide. Sir, we are saying
that it's very practical. There is so much, a huge amount of sewage is being generated. What are you going to do?
No, sir. Delhi, see, why we hold that Delhi has enough water till whatever extent it can actually expand itself. Not groundwater. It is recycle, reuse.
Yes.
You have to treat it and recycle and reuse it for all your non-potable uses. You don't have to put it into the river.
What is the present situation?
No. So the present situation has to change. Yes. River and sewer can have no limits. We cannot agree to putting any treated or untreated wastewater into our rivers or other water bodies. We cannot agree to that. 10 BOD, 30 BOD, 40 BOD, no.
You are being impractical.
Let me be impractical.
This is
what the state has also agreed. The state has agreed on this, that river and sewers will not mix. It is today there is an order which is coming.
Please add name of the project after 1984.
Please
name project after 1984. Money having been spent on it since 1984. Project name Ganga
Action Plan, New Action Plan.
Okay.
74. Okay. Actually, yes. sir is the, but sir, the fact is that 74 was the Water Act, and the Water Act should have actually ensured that we required these projects only because Water Act was not implemented.
Then we are
ओके इसको नितिन इसको आगे ऐड कर लो यस नाउ अदर एक्शंस रिवर्स एज ए कल्चरल इकोलॉजिकल एंड सोशल कॉमन्स व्हिच वी कैन हियर
you have anything else on the pollution part of it or that's the last part of it?
That is the last part. You want
in our discussion cycle, there were a lot of discussions about this polluter pays too simple and we should have a criminal that is the recommendation from the group.
You see, that...
That has not come anywhere.
No, that will come under this.
Okay, you come out. That's
yeah, in this. Rivers as a cultural, ecological and social commons shall be legally acknowledged. So, what we are saying is we need a river law. So, we can bring in this point about a river law. River law here. Then, annual status reports of rivers shall be prepared and made public. And we are also talking in terms of red list of rivers. Hydrological data on rivers shall be made public. Communities and Panchayat Raj institutions shall be at the focus and the primary stage of river basin governance, as they are the primary stakeholders in ensuring continued health of the rivers. River watch programs and networks, blah blah blah, that we will bring in. Now, demand side management, water management shall be introduced in urban areas and industries. Moreover, increased irrigation efficiencies through adoption of appropriate cropping patterns, minimization of virtual water export, and promotion of natural and dry land farming, and such other water conservation measures shall be taken up in every river basin, district and region. The existing institutional arrangements...
I think the demand side management is not only for cities, it's for rural and entire basin.
So, basin-wide. So, basin-wide. The existing institutional arrangements including regulatory mechanisms on rivers in the country shall be revisited and reformed in a participatory and transparent manner. You may like to use more strong words here, like CWC is hopeless, worthless,
the whole issue is that regulatory mechanism should be democratized. I think it's not just participated. The whole issue is that, the whole
revisited, reformed, and democratized. No, they have come out with this and they think that is the best. then all infrastructure planning with a potential to impact the river shall be transparent, consultative, and based on a thorough, cumulative, strategic, and environmental impact assessment procedure with the underlying principle that the river has been inherited. And hearing this, your point about consent from the communities, that should be
I think consent should come right up front.
Yeah, I'm only flagging.
Okay.
I'm only flagging.
Okay.
Manoj ji.
Ji.
I just wanted to add one point more. That's what we also discussed and presented in the gallery. One is to kind of challenge and review the kind of profit-oriented growth, GDP-oriented kind of development. broad model of development that actually foiled this river crisis, no? And also other multi-stages crisis. So I feel that has to be reflected somewhere.
Can we take that to the preamble?
Yeah.
Where that?
Yeah, but then there has to be concrete, way for kind of statement. So I don't know how it is.
Can you give me a formulation for that? If you can give me a formulation, maybe a paragraph. Okay, now all industrial products, now this is again, there was a difference of opinion on this. All industrial products shall have their water footprints included in pricing of the product. Cost rationalization as a policy will hold industries accountable to the cost actual cost that get externalized as an uncontested convention at this point of time. So maybe the actual cost of a bottle of water is much more than what it is being sold at. But because there are so many different kinds of visible and invisible subsidies, which is bringing it down to 10 or 15 rupees, that it has become such a popular thing. If it were, instead of 10 or 15 rupees, if it were 50 or 100 rupees, maybe there would not be any bottled water around. So that is the idea.
I think a point has been made here, which you need to take cognizance of. I think the lady made that.
Yeah.
And talk about your point over
yeah.
So I think first there are two principles here. One is that we should not give the option that anybody who can pay can destroy
yeah.
those who can't pay. This is especially true for bottled water. Because what you are saying is people who are rich are currently bacteria free, but those who are not, then you know, you can just go that. So I think you need to rethink this out a little bit. Secondly, I don't think it's just a matter of costing. I think what we need to do is to build up standards of water use. I don't think the threat is to mineral water. I think the threat is to other production. I think there are a lot of industry which uses much more water than they should, because they don't want to invest in an upgradation of the technology. They want to maximize profits, etc. So I think one has to start setting up standards, and one has to insist on transparency, because government is not going to monitor these. So you have a transparency by which people can monitor what is happening. I mean, I don't have to go into specific examples. So I would suggest that let's take that point on view. Otherwise, this would become a very negative point. So if you are rich, you can destroy your
country.
Is it
the way
we
are talking about use of water for agriculture? Let's have a policy for use of water for industry. When they have money, we will not allow them to consume that water for industry. In the name of policy, we should bring that, and it should be transparent, and it should not be coming, so community can do marketing systematically. Because otherwise they say we have money and we put footprint also. No problem. That people buy even that possible.
And if there can be a point also mentioned as to, I think there was one point about transparency. There has to be transparency in allocation of water to the industry from river projects. We don't have that.
In fact, we have a policy for water use by industry. That should be.
How many gallons of water?
See, when we are saying a policy, that policy should automatically take care of that as well.
In fact, what I would suggest for you, and this is of course partly my own interest in RTI and like so, is that through the minister you can present a list of information that her ministry under Section 4 of the RTI should proactively make public. Now this should include your water flows that you talked about earlier, allocations of water, the standard, the usage. I mean, let companies declare to the ministry what is the water per unit they are using for production, and let this be a part of the Section 4 declaration. Now this is not difficult for her, and if you tell her, she might be willing to get this done.
Okay, now coming to this, the science of river, I think I don't think this will be contested. The science of river as a form of scientific discipline should be promoted.
No, what does that mean?
Pardon me?
Sometimes this use of scientific, temper, this enlightenment thing.
You see, today we seem to presume that hydrology as a science of water includes rivers, which is not correct. River has a science of its own, because river has a life of its own. And so that science of a river, as different from hydrology, should be promoted. That's what I'm saying.
I think the point that we made here in my mind is that we mustn't look at rivers only through a narrow hydrological scientific perspective. There are many different types of knowledge bases which are relevant for understanding rivers. So we should spell it out. It includes biodiversity, it includes cultural and social and historical parameters, and say that Rivers must be studied and understood through a much broader perspective than the narrow perspective of hydrology, which has currently been
Let's not
use the term science given that makes people uncomfortable.
It's not only
just
one science
or
one
stream.
Discipline, science is so late.
From primary level to higher education.
Yeah, aapka point tha. आपने कुछ पॉल्यूशन पे आपने कहा था ना कि वो आया नहीं
सर वन मोर पॉइंट भी प्रोफेसर ही वेंट अप ही सेड द इशू ऑफ कंजर्विंग द बायोडायवर्सिटी सो आई जस्ट सजेस्ट वन सेंटेंस सी क्रिटिकल बायोडायवर्सिटी एरिया शुड बी आइडेंटिफाइड व्हाट रेगुलर स्टेट एंड लेट हंटर्स एंड नेटिव स्पीशीज शुड बी प्रिजर्व्ड एज इंडिकेटर स्पीशीज ऑफ हेल्दी रिवर सिस्टम्स इफ यू कैन ऐड दिस
environment
Also
of the people who are assigned to implement the law. It's not there for those people. Sitting in the pollution board, sitting in the ministry who take decision, they are not liable for anything.
It's a general problem with the government that they are only liable for acts of commission.
One clarification and one addition. The clarification is that under the Water Act also, for water pollution, there is criminal liability. The problem is that when the Pollution Control Board takes those cases to the High Court for prosecuting the criminals, the cases drag on for 10 years and at the end of the day, High Court lets them off with a fine.
Fine.
But the criminal liability provision is there. In fact, there are lawyers who are recommending that we should dilute that provision because there is criminal liability, nobody really wants to enforce that provision. If you were to do civil penalties or a fine, there is no civil penalty. For water pollution, there is no procedure to levy a 20 lakh rupee fine. It's only either you go to jail or there is, you're kind of let off. It's kind of a 1-0 provision. I'm saying there is a gray area, but the criminal liability already provision exists. The real issue is about improving the court system in order to prosecute these cases quickly, number one, and strengthening the governance of these pollution control boards. The point that emerged in our group, the governance structure of these pollution control boards, where the polluters are sitting on the governing boards, needs to be changed. Right now, it's the polluters
who my request is, in your groups, things were discussed. If there is something which you feel is not covered here, please give that in a formulation to us.
Manoj, the word area of rivers of the terrain of contestation, conflicts, conflict resolution, nothing has come here. And we gave you three minutes, which is quite well summarized.
Yeah, okay. So, so conflicts and
conflicts and conflict resolution.
Any other point?
On the point of criminal liability, we should probably say making procedures easier and also the burden of proof lower. So that will make it
on the okay, so one was the point about conflicts which has not come. Is there any other thing?
I think a river policy.
River law.
River
law
will come after policy. River policy.
Yes.
There was something that I was wondering if we should be also thinking land acquisition. Since we are talking of integrity of river system, acquiring land around the river, land, forest, has also to be treated as part of integral to the river system, because are we talking of river as in just river or?
The regulatory zone idea is there. Already regulatory zone.
No,
in land acquisition terms I am talking about.
Let us first deal with
I think there are two issues here. First of all, as you probably know, the R&R law today, which has recently been, I think, has a fair number of provisions of sorts. In fact, I feel that, but for the fact that it might get amended and weakened, we could pick up some of those provisions, like for example, 80% and 70% of the population has to be agreed to a particular land acquisition. We can say, why not apply the same principle to rivers. If you want to divert a river or use it for water, just let 80% of the people who are using that river system or dependent on it agree to it. So that's one. Secondly, any acquisition of land now around rivers will get covered under the R&R law. So what you need to ask yourself is what else you want. Thirdly, the way this is formulated, if that land forms into, for example, a catchment area or a flood plain, etc., then of course it will also come under the river system. But I would suggest saying that if you are going to ask for a policy, in fact, one of the things that could happen out of this workshop is that you form a small group to draft out a policy for the government.
As a platform where all the people working for rivers actually come together, and if possible, maybe meet once a year. And if that meeting could also be like India Rivers Week, as a part of that India Rivers Forum meeting, annual meeting, something of that kind. So the draft of that India Rivers Forum has been provided to each one of you. If you have suggestions, please provide to us. We have the emails of all of you.